Thea Eyes nearing the corner by the 550. Regal Gleam eventually worked its way to the top. Steadied them up a little. Regal Gleam by one count to Moz Off So Fancy. Down on the inside, travelling third, coming around the corner. Going up Sporting Image now as they make the bend. And then Massachusetts, followed by Bow Count, who copped a cut with a Persuader. And Chocolate Holic starting to run on very well down the outside. Regal Gleam, though, stoked up at the 200. Led the way from Count to Moz Off. Down the outside is Chocolate Holic coming with its run. Regal Gleam is the leader. Chocolate Holic is trying to bridge the margin. Regal Gleam stopping. Chocolate Holic is lunging. Regal Gleam, I might have held on.
Oh, I guess even with the support, whether they liked it or not, it was over the odds early.
Yeah, she opened up a pretty big price apparently, but we're really confident today, Adam. She was a good run the other day in 1,000, and we just knew it was going to be a tad short. Stepping up to the 1,200 today, her work's been right up to the mark, and obviously it was a bit of a downer when she drew the outside, but she was quick enough. We were nice and positive out the gates, and a couple of cheap sectionals by Aaron, give it a nice ride, and it was a good win.
We've seen it with so many of your horses, the ability to be able to show the speed out of the gates, then settle and relax and be able to show that kick late, and again, she did that.
Yeah, well, they're all nice and fit and well-educated, and the staff do a great job, so she was able to bring her work to the races and do a good job. I think it's a good win because the second horse looks like it's got a pretty bright future, I think, so it's good to get one over Puff anyway.
Certainly is. You don't get that too often as well sometimes when you're taking on the Williams stable. Now, the time that she had her off, how much stronger has she come back and matured?
Yeah, she's come back a night. She's a really big filly. Like, she was always, she did a good job as a two-year-old and won a couple of races there, but we knew once she turned three and matured a bit, she was always going to be a pretty handy filly. So she's gone and done that, so it's good.
There's a bit of excitement in the weekend. The Bolton, first among equals, back, but you haven't had much luck with the barriers.
No, well, General Groove drew one and the other bloke drew 12 first among equals. So they're both going good. So a bit of luck in running. Hopefully we can play a part.
Is there a winning chance first up?
First among equals?
Yes.
Yeah, for sure. Yep. His trial was good. He never trial was great, but obviously the barrier is tricky. But no, he's going really well and he's a really good chance for sure.
We look forward to seeing his return. Congratulations.
Thanks, Adam.
Grab winning jockey now, Aaron Mitchell. And Aaron, really nice ride there by yourself. You had to do a little bit of work to get across, but then you were able to relax.
Yeah, that's right. We had to do a little bit of work early, and we were able to get probably two cheap sectionals, and it was just a matter of just being able to hold on to her for as long as possible, and she just held on.
Did you feel like you'd done too much work earlier, or were you confident that she had got the rest that she needed?
I was pretty confident. We got a pretty good breather, and we didn't, you know, get attacked the whole way. So that was always in our favour.
You must have been confident stepping up to the 1,200 metres as well. She's really wanted that.
Yeah, she's been looking for that. She's taken a couple of runs to get fit now, and she's rock hard fit and ready to go.
Well done, mate. Good ride.
Cheers, mate.